the power of putting this group of people, these kinds of people that we've got right here, in a room and just taking a very few minutes of time to come up with some ideas is very, very powerful. So think about how we organize ourselves and we get rolling into this thing. How many of these ideas are going to be flowing through the organization, and how many great results we're going to have with this. It was part of an organization that was trying to reinvent itself right after a major consolidation, actually an acquisition of another healthcare system. We merged. Make a long story short, we needed to tear down silos. We had major silos because we were two separate organizations that came together, and there were barriers. There were still competitive factors between the two. So we had the smart idea to create 10 discrete strategic business units or service lines. And so what we got so caught up in is developing these self-contained service lines, 10 of them, and all we did was, instead of tearing down two major silos that we had in the organization, we created 10 silos, 10 service lines with that had their own separate silo, because all of them had to do their own thing. They didn't want to listen to anybody else. They didn't collaborate together as an organization. They had their own overhead structure, and they had their own organization. That's exactly the opposite of what our organization is all about, and it's just exactly the opposite of what we need to do here in our organization. Okay.
This was actually rapid fire from all the folks on the team. One thing was really clean up your own house. Make sure that your staff are being productive throughout their workday, working their entire shift. They feel that our system is pretty lax on that. Reduce or eliminate incremental overtime. Stop excluding physicians. And we did talk about the fact that DMG is being included in this project as well. Stop information-only sharing meetings, which means that we need to develop a better communication plan. We have some opportunities.
Second one is going outside the VAT process. The VAT process was kind of cumbersome and took a long time. And Mark was able to work with a lot of vendors directly on a very quick process level to make changes in pricing. And 7 of his 10 plans were able to be implemented quickly going outside of that process in order to save some funds.
But one of the things is that making yourself available. You know, we need to reduce our meetings that are meetings about meetings and just information, and making yourself available. So I'll cancel something if I know it is to specifically address something that has to do with these 100-day projects. That's my top priority, and I think that everybody needs to put that across to everyone. That is our priority, and if that's what we're working on, the meetings that we have had in place for 2 or 3 years, they can wait.
I heard a lot of things today. Here's one of the results. The suggestion to go to quarterly management meetings, done.